MRT. No other three letters could bring such stress for any Metro Manila commuter who has had to suffer long lines, overcrowded trains, and often substandard service just to get to work every day. But what if we can transform this into this? A train station that is in itself a destination. These models are the brainchildren of architecture students Bea Villoria and Noel Narciso from the De La Salle College of St. Benilde. The project designed an MRT station that can accommodate the ballooning number of commuters while making sure that they can easily move around from point A to point B.
The design challenge was basically with a speculated context, and that means that given that population of Filipinos are exponentially increasing up to the year 2050, what if it increases so much that the demand for public mobility transport is requires two extra concourses above the existing one?
We imagine EDSA to be a spine of a growing city, and each station will be like nodes of the city.
Veering away from the traditional design, Noel and Bea reimagined train stations to have strategically placed ramps that would seamlessly reroute pedestrian circulation.
As a problem of the usual Filipino commuter is that we don't know where to go and that we always have to enter the roads and cross. Even if MMDA already has screens, people are still trying to find a way to go around. This is the current EDSA Ayala MRT. So you'll notice the very low ceilings over here, and that my design intervention is poised in such a way that we can kind of rise from these slopes and then enter the bridge, the diagonal bridge, which then makes you avoid having to walk or jaywalk here.
I utilized a rotunda design for my project. Kasi pag rotunda, it uses less space and it directs the flow of traffic. So by using ramps, it's also more PWD friendly. Nakakapasok yung sunlight and there's natural ventilation. Kasi yung current state ng mga station natin right now, LRT or MRT, madilim siya, kulob.
Both also advocate more green spaces by adding a sky garden at the uppermost level. Here, tired passengers can actually de-stress and appreciate a view of the city while waiting for their next trip.
In a train station, all we want to do is leave. But we don't make the experience pleasant for the Filipino kasi we have low ceilings, even the dirt on the floor is really bad. It's very cramped all the time. Escalators are really very thin.
Kasi minsan tatama rin yung mga tao, dun lang sila sa lower level. So dahil kumbaga parang perks yung pag-akyat sa taas na there's a garden up there, they could visit.
Too good to be true, but an experience that Juan de la Cruz has long deserved. These aspiring architects hope that their models could inspire the Philippine government to go full speed in improving our public transportation system. Until then, there's no hitting the brakes on dreaming big.
We don't want them to lose their idealism as a designer. The moment you teach them the limit of design in school, they won't be able to see the possibilities of what imagination can bring them.
The number one takeaway is that Filipinos today are suffering. They're really, really suffering. And there's a very large potential for governments to actually give Filipinos better kind of standards for urban transport. And that maybe from Bea's and my prototypes, the ones who are viewing this can also extract maybe new ideas should the proper contracting, engineering, and architecture body be given the chance to create new kinds of stations.
And that's another inspiring story on Think Possible. If you know of another problem solver or simply a good Samaritan changing the world one deed at a time, send us an email at ancthinkpossible@gmail.com. For more positive stories on your feed, make sure to like and follow us on Facebook and subscribe to our YouTube channel. We'd love to hear from you.